Okay, fantastic. Would anybody else like to have a try? Don't be shy, guys. It's okay if you make mistakes, not a big deal. Lisa, would you like to have a go?
Hi.
How are you doing?
Can you hear me?
Yes, nice and clear. Would you like to try reading number two for me, the fast food one?
Yes.
Yeah.
Fast food is the backbone of society. It is the sustenance that allows us to work for extended periods of time, despite our growing exhaustion. KFC, Free the Chicken, or KFC is precisely the type of food that has an adequate number of calories, which can boast productively for up to 12 hours after consumption. Following the proliferation of the KFC chain worldwide, we have seen a global increase in IQ of one per year.
Yeah, not too bad, not too bad. So there's quite a few things we can actually talk about with that particular performance. Okay, so firstly, there was a couple of interesting pronunciations with some of the vowel sounds. Now, one of the best ways to fix this is just by listening and copying off a native speaker. Okay, so just for example, see if you can say these ones. If you copy off me, try this one. This one is periods, periods.
Periods.
Periods. So three sounds, periods.
Periods.
Yes, now link them together, periods.
Periods.
Yeah, nice, nice, good. Another one is this one. So this vowel sound, the double O, is pronounced oo, boost, boost.
Boost.
Yeah, so what you're saying is boost, like that, right? Oh. Whereas we're going for a boost. The difference between a boo and a boo is the position of your tongue inside your mouth, right? When you're saying boo, what you're doing is you're pulling your tongue back to the back of your mouth near your throat, okay? Whereas when you go oo, oo, the tongue is kind of forward near the front of your mouth. Okay, so can you try that for me again? Boost, boost.
Boost.
Yeah, a little bit closer, right? So what you'll find is, I don't know how many of you know about this theory, but in English, technically speaking, there are a total of 40, I think it was 42 different sounds. I think it was, oh no, 44, sorry, 24 consonants and 20 vowels, okay? And the difference between most of the vowels is just the position of the tongue inside your mouth. Right. So that's something which obviously if you're like a native Chinese speaker, for example, it might be a bit difficult for you to get used to because you're not used to making those specific sounds. But if you're wondering what the difference is between your speech and a native speaker, that's probably one of the big contributors. Yeah. Now, of course, there were also some other kind of difficult words in here. So maybe you're not too familiar with the word Kentucky. Those are generally fine. Those are just new vocabulary things. Okay. Now, the other thing that you want to be a little bit careful of is where you're stopping in the middle of a sentence. Okay. So one thing I noticed, for example, is that as you were reading, you had a little bit of a pause between places like between global and increase, even though it's a word group.
Right?
So yes. One of the things I always say is if you need to stop a little bit longer at the pause, but try to make sure that when you have a section of sentence like this, we have seen a global increase in IQ of one per year. You want to get from the start to the finish without a pause, if possible, even if you're speaking a little bit slower.
Yeah. Well, thank you.
No problems. All right. Thank you very much. Well done. Great job.